Good morning, student. I am going to start chapter number 10. Chapter name is a religious form movement and class for 7th. So in this chapter we will study about the different religious reformers. So two religious reformers, Sufi movement and Bhakti movement, take place during the medieval period of India. The main cause for the rise of Bhakti movement and Sufi movement was complex caste system and social structure. So first one is a Sufi movement. So Sufi movement, the word Sufi is derived from the word Safa, which means a pure and simple. So Sufi came from Persia in 11th century CE and settled in the various part of India. So the main word Sufi means, put stress on love and devotion as the means of coming closer to God. So word Sufi means we should put stress on love and devotion as a mean if we want to come close to God. So the main principle of Sufism, the first one is God is the one and all powerful. God has all power. God is one and he has all power. And all men are his children. To love God means to love mankind. Tolerance for other religions and sects. Because God teaches that we should love all the religion and we should respect all the religion. So these are main principle of Sufism. Respect for all human beings. People should follow the teaching of peer and guru. So in the Sufi movement, there is a one peer and murid. So peer means guru and we should follow the, and murid means a shishya. We can say that a shishya. So peer is a guru. We should follow the principle and guidelines and teaching of a guru, and we should love the human beings, and we should love the all religions, respect all the religions. So Sufism expressed their devotion and their love to God through a music and poetry. The most important way of expressing the love and devotion to God is a qawwali. Qawwali music that is popularized and followed by the Sufism. So Sufi orders. So Sufi orders means the Sufi saints were organized into 12 orders, also known as a silsila. So the most popular Sufi orders were Suhrawardi order, that is established by Sheikh Zakariya, that is a Sufi saint in the 12th century. And second Sufi order that was established, known as a Chishti order, by Monuddin Chishti. So there are 12 Sufi orders known as a silsilas. The most popular Sufi orders, the first one is a Suhrawardi, that is established by Sheikh Zakariya in the twelfth century, and second one is a Chishti order that is established by Monuddin Chishti. So next one is the Sufi reformers. So there are different Sufi reformers of the under the Sufi movements who preach the people and guide the people in the different way. So first one is a Khwaja Moinuddin Chishti. So Khwaja Moinuddin Chishti, he was born in Central Asia and came to India around CE 1192. He lived in Ajmer and died in CE 1236 and buried in Ajmer. So his loving called popularly known as a Grib Niwaj, and his dargah at Ajmer is visited by thousands of people. So he is the first Sufi reformers known as a Khwaja Moinuddin Chishti, who also established a Chishti Sufi order known as a Chishti order. The second one is a Baba Farid. He was a famous Sufi saint who lived in Ajodhan. And he used Punjabi literature and Punjabi language to preach the people for their teachings. And some of his verses were also included in Sri Guru Granth Sahib. And his shrine in Pakpattam the Punjab provinces of Pakistan is visited by thousands of devotees. So next one Sufi saint is Nizamuddin Uliya of Delhi. So Nizamuddin lived in Delhi and preached religious tolerance and love for mankind. So he put main emphasis means we should be a tolerant toward all the religions and we should love the mankind. So he said that God is the one, whether we call him Allah, Ishwar, Bhagwan, Ram. So he said that God is the one and we call him by different name. And he is a supreme being, means he is a powerful. And Nizamuddin Uliya of Delhi, popularly known as a Hazrat Nizamuddin, and his shrine is also in Delhi. And he is a third Sufi reformer. The next one is Nasiruddin Chiragh Dilli. He was another commanding figure of Sufism in Delhi. The next one is the impact of Sufism. So first one, Sufi saints, all the Sufi saints, Mohinuddin Chishti and Baba Fareed, Nizamuddin Uliya. So he all promotes universal brotherhood and it also promotes Hindu-Muslim unity. Then he promotes equality among people, then foster the Muslim rulers to be tolerant toward all other religions. So he also brought the Hindu-Muslim unity, brought the Hindu-Muslims closer to each other. He also influenced a poet of this period. He played very important role in spreading the feeling of love, tolerance, respect and universal brotherhood. They said that we are all brothers, we are all equals and we are children of a one God. The next one is the next movement, Bhakti movement. The Bhakti means meditation, devotion to God. If we want to meet with the God, we want to come closer to God, then we should meditate and we should give intense devotion to God. So it stress union of the individual with God, means they follow the principle of Atma and Paramatma. So devotion to God means one total surrender to God, means we should surrender to the God. It emphasizes the brotherhood of mankind, opposed caste, create and racial discrimination, means they forbid all kind of discrimination on the basis of caste, culture and race. So the famous saints, they under the Bhakti movement known as Nayanars and Alwar saint, who worship the different Lord, like first one Shiva, Shiva. Nayanars worship the Shiva and Alwars worship the Vishnu. So they worship the different God. So like the Sufi saints, Bhakti saint also preached supremacy of God, love of mankind, religious tolerance and importance of good deeds. And they created an atmosphere of mutual trust, peaceful coexistence between Hindu and Muslims. So characteristics of the Bhakti movement means they believe in a one God, surrender of self to will of God, faith in Guru and non-belief in the caste system, idol worship and ritualism. So Bhakti movement started in South India and it is divided into two categories. First one is Alwars and second one is known as a Nayanars. So Nayanars were those who worship the Lord Shiva. There were 63 Nayanars, there were 63 Nayanars. And all belong to a different caste, like workers, patients, porters, artisans, hunters, and they worship the Lord Shiva. So most famous among them were Samandar, Surinder, and Mankisagar and Apar. And there were two sets of completions of their song, Tevaram and Trivatskam. So next one is the Alwars. So Alwars were those who worship the Lord Vishnu. And they were 12 in numbers and like the Nayanars, they belong to a different caste and creed. And their song was complied in Divya and Pravandam and Alwar worship the Lord Vishnu. The next one is the Bhakti saints. So, first Bhakti saints, there are many Bhakti saints like Shankaracharya, Ramanuj, Ramanand, Kabir, Namdev, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Mirabai were great saints of the Bhakti cult and they belong to South India. And all of them preached principle of a Bhakti cult. And first one is Shankaracharya. The Shankaracharya, the most philosopher of India, most famous philosopher of India, born in Kerala in the 8th century. And he advocated the oneness of individual soul and the Supreme God means the Atma and principle of Atma and Paramatma. He called the world around us as a Maya. And according to Shankaracharya, if we want to meet with the God, then we should follow the right path, right knowledge, and according to do, we should have to do a right actions. The next one is Ramanuj. He was born in Chennai in CE 1166 and he preached the principle of Bhakti cult in South India and he used the local language for the more understanding of the people and he was against the caste system and preached equality of all men. The next South saint, Bhakti saint is Ramanand. He was born he was a follower of Ramanuj and he was born at Prayag, placed in Allahabad and lived there and also at Banaras. And he also preached the worship of Ram in place of Vishnu. And he also was against the idol worship and his disciple included Ravidas, who was a cobbler, Kabir, who was a weaver, Sina, who was a barber, and Sadhana, who was a bhajan. The next one is Kabir. The next South saint under the Bhakti movement was Kabir. Kabir was a weaver who wrote a poetry also. His doha, full of deep meaning, are recited by Hindu and Muslim alike. And he preached the existence of one supreme God. And he also preached the people that we should follow the right action and be tolerant towards all the religions. He said that there is only one God and he has all the power. And he is called by different names, Ram, Rahim, Allah, Hari. And he stressed on Hindu-Muslim unity and strongly against the idol worship, pilgrimages, rituals, religious superstitions. And his followers were called Kabir Panthis. The next saint under the Bhakti cult was Shri Guru Nanak Dev Ji. We are all familiar about his personality. He was born in 1469 at Talwandi in Punjab, now in Nankana Sahib in Shekhupura, the district of Pakistan. He preached universal brotherhood, unity of God and tolerance. And he greatly put emphasis on purity of conduct and character. He said that if we want to meet the God, if we want to get the salvation and freedom from the cycle of death and birth, then our conduct and our character should be pure and fair. And he advocated middle path in which spiritual life could be combined with the duties of a household. He said that with the household activities, we should try to achieve the spiritual knowledge and enlightenment. And he was a founder of Sikhism, the religion of a Sikh. The next Sufi reformers, Bhakti saint under the Bhakti movement is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was a popular Bhakti saint of Bengal. And he was devotee of Lord Krishna and composed many songs and hymns in the praise of God. He believed in Bhakti music and Bhakti Kirtan because he believed that it is only a one way through which we can express the love and devotion towards God. And he was accompanied by the large number of followers, both Hindu and Muslims. And he rejected the caste system and preached equality and brotherhood. The next one saint under the Bhakti cult was Mirabai. She belonged to Rajasthan and she renounced the worldly activities and world luxuries and comforts and dedicated her life to Lord Krishna. He worshipped the Lord Krishna, and bhajans of Meera are sung even now all over the world, and she is a devotee of Lord Krishna. The next one is a Maratha saints under the Bhakti and saint movement, Sufi movement. So Maratha saints between the 13th and 17th century also created a feeling of brotherhood, love, peace, tolerance among the people, and taught the value of self-sacrifice and patriotism. The word patriotism means love and devotion for one's own country. So first Maratha saint was Saint Janeshwar, or also known as Dhaneshwar. He expressed a deep love for God through his bhajans and musics and through his songs. He was born in Apigon on the bank of river Godavari in CE 1275, and he worshipped the Lord Krishna. And he died at the young age of 21 in 1296, and his religious poems are called Abhangans, and he wrote a commentary on the Bhagavad Gita called, that is why he is called a Dhaneshwari. He was the first Maratha saint, Saint Janeshwar. The next one is a Maratha saint, is a Saint Tukaram. He composed devotional song and music in the praise of Lord Krishna, and he called the Lord Krishna Vithoba. And priest quality of mankind, he was a contemporary and similar of Shivaji and influenced him greatly. The next one saint, the Maratha saint, is a Saint Namdev. He was another saint belonging to the Bhakti cult, and he was first a tailor, then he became a Pandit, and finally became a Bhakti saint and priest, a pupil for universal brotherhood, love, peace, tolerance and respect towards all religion regarding the equality of mankind. And his poem written in Marathi breathe a spirit of intense love and devotion to God. So both Sufi and Bhakti movements helped to establish the environment of love and peace in India. So next one is the impact of Bhakti movement. The teaching of Bhakti saint both brought Hindu and Muslim unity like the Sufi movement. So like the Sufi movement, Bhakti movement also brought the Hindu and Muslim closer and create a spirit of unity among them. The caste system, Bhakti movement reduced the rigidity of caste system and also gave a opportunity to the lower caste and the lower people to participate in the religious functions also. And it also gave a boost and development of the regional language and literature. And it also puts the stress on the simplicity and on the simple living and right conduct, right knowledge and right faith. The next one, similarities between the Bhakti and Sufi movement. So similarity between both is that both were against the caste system. Both believed that rituals and religious functions are unnecessary. There is no need to perform any religious function to please the God. Then both of them preached their masses in the simple language, that is simple and easy for the people, for the common man. And both preached simple living and love, tolerance, kind, purity, charity and simplicity of a character. So in this chapter, we have studied about the different Bhakti movements and Sufi saints and Sufi movements. Thanks and have a nice day.